Hello everyone, in this video for the Scrapy playbook, we're going to look at how we can save our data to CSV files using Scrapy feed exporters. First, we will look at how to tell Scrapy to save to CSV files from the command line. Next, we will set up feed settings in our Scrapy project so that our data will be saved automatically every time the spider runs. And finally, we will look at some of the more advanced Scrapy feed exporter functionality that allows us to create dynamic paths to our CSV files and split our data into batches. All the code you see in this tutorial is shared with you in a written guide, whose link is in the description. Okay, let's get started. For this project, we'll be using a very simple books to scrape scraper. So all this will do is scrape every single book from this page and output the name, the price, and is in stock. And we have set it up a book item that is defined in our items.py file. So when I run the scraper, books to scrape, we will see that it is scraping all the data from the page and outputting it to the terminal. We can see here, but it's not being saved anymore. So the first thing what we want to do is save this data to a CSV file, and we'll do that using the command line. So I'll just clear this, and again, scrapy crawl book spider. And to save it to a CSV file using the command line, it's very simple. Let's go dash O, and then I'm going to call it data.csv. And when I run the spider this time, what we'll see over here, we now have a data.csv file. Okay, now there's two options when we do this. Small o will append the data to the existing file. So we can see here we have 21 lines in this file at the moment. If I run this again, it should just append more lines to the bottom of this file. So as we can see here again, it is just appended now basically the same data again. If however, we want to replace the file every time we run the scraper, what we do, instead of small o, big O. And I run it, instead of 42 lines we'll have in this, we will now have 21. So what this did in this case is replaced the entire file with the data. So this works, and depending on your project, telling Scrapy to save data from the command line might be good enough for you. However, it isn't best practice. The best way to save data to CSV files within Scrapy is to define Scrapy feeds either in your settings.py file or in the spider itself. In the written guide that goes along with this tutorial, we've shown you how to do both options. First, how to set up a Scrapy feed within your settings.py file. So this would be a global Scrapy feed that affects all spiders in a project. Or alternatively, you could define a Scrapy feed on one specific spider by defining custom settings and then in those custom settings, defining the Scrapy feed. First, we will set up a global Scrapy feed in our settings.py file that will take effect on every spider we run. To do so, all we need to do is copy and paste this bit of code here into our settings.py file. So opening back up our editor, we'll go into the settings.py file and we can place this code anywhere we want. And I'm just going to change this instead of data.csv, I'm just going to call it data global so that we can see the difference between this CSV file and the one we're running from the command line. I'm going to save this, clear our terminal, and then run scrapy crawl book spider. And just to note, we don't need a dash O annotation in this case. I'm going to run my scraper. And we can see now we have a data_global.csv with all our data inside of it. So what we've just done is we've created a global Scrapy feed. So any spider that runs in this project will use this feed and output the data into data_global.csv. That's okay. But what if we want to have a specific feed for every individual spider? One way of doing this is we can go into the spider itself and adding custom settings. So taking the code from the documentation page, I'm just going to add that in here. So I'm going to use a custom settings and then define a feed. And just to clearly identify that this data is coming from this feed, I'm going to call it spider. Okay. And then when I run this code, what we will see over here is we'll have data underscore spider.csv. So instead of using the global Scrapy feed that we defined in our settings.py file, in this case, because we've defined custom setting inside in our spider itself, it actually uses the feed we've defined here and outputs the data into data underscore spider.csv. That's great, but one problem you might have noticed with how we're saving the data so far is that the file path and the file name is fixed, meaning all the data will go into the same file, which isn't ideal. To solve this, we'll use one of Scrapy Feed's more advanced functionality that allows us to create unique file paths every time our spider runs. We're going to implement this at the global level within our project, so we will remove the custom settings from our spider. And open our settings.py file. Here we can see that we're saving our data into a data underscore global.csv file. However, we're going to use Scrapy Feed's stored URI parameters so that all our data will be saved into a data folder, which contains a folder for each spider, and each file will be called spider name underscore the time the job started. To do so, I'm just going to copy and paste in the file format now. And as you can see here, we'll be storing the data into a data folder. Name will be the spider name. It's going to be pulled dynamically from the spider that is running. And then the actual file name itself will be the spider name, followed by the time that I ran. Now, every time we run a spider in this project, it'll create a new CSV file with the data that's clearly marked with the spider name and the time the job ran. I'm going to save this and save the bookspider.py. Clear this here, and then when I run my spider again, what we should see over here is a data folder. So we have our data folder. Inside of it, there's a book spider. And now the file name is book spider underscore the time that I ran. And we can see the data here. So as you can imagine, using dynamic file paths is much better than using fixed file paths, especially when scraping in production, as it gives us much more robust and structured data storage setup when we are scraping larger volumes of data. Another inbuilt functionality of Scrapy Feeds is the ability to split our saved data into batches instead of saving all the data from a scrape into a single large file. This can be very useful when we're doing large crawls. To do so, we're just going to go into our settings.py file. And what we need to do is we need to change our Scrapy Feeds setting here. So I'm going to paste in the data. To enable batch saving, what we need to do is add a batch item on item count. And here I'm just going to set it to 5. So every 5 items scraped, it will create a new CSV file. We also need to add a unique ID to each one of the CSV files, otherwise it's going to overwrite the previous ones. So what I've done is basically I've just added a batch and then a batch ID. So it'll increment a new batch ID every time we run this thing. So when I run the scraper now, let's clear this and run the scraper. What we'll see over here is new batches. So 5 items, 5 items, 5 items. This is the exact same as here, but instead of having 21 items, it's after splitting the item scraped up into batches. So this is very useful if you have a very large scrape and you want to get the data out periodically. There we go. In this tutorial, we've covered how to save our data to CSV files using Scrapy Feed exporters. If you like this video, then give it a like and subscribe to our YouTube channel if you'd like to see more Scrapy tutorials like this. Or you could check out the scrapyplaybook.com for more Scrapy guides and resources. The link is in the description. Also, if you have any questions, then just leave them in the comments below and we will get back to you. So until the next time, happy scraping.